Good morning, student. In today's lecture, we are going to study about the reproductive system, the life cycle of the starfish. Okay? In our last video or in past few days, we have already completed or we are doing the study type study on the echinodermata, that is on starfish. Okay? We have already dealt with the systematic position of starfish, then the morphological structures, then pedicellaria, digestive system, the digestive glands, respiration in starfish, water vascular system, then excretion in starfish, nervous system, sense organ, circulatory system in starfish. So now we are going to see the last part of the starfish, that is the reproductive system and its life cycle. Okay, so reproductive system in starfish, they are unisexual, that is sexes are separate. There is no sexual dimorphism is observed. Okay, it has a 5 pairs of gonads and 1 pair in each arm, which is based at the or situated at the base of the arm. Okay, the gonad is enclosed in a genital sinus. Okay, and from each gonad they give rise to a gonoduct, which opens to the outside on the aboral surface of the aboral surface by a minute pore known as a gonopore. Okay, and from this gonopore the gonads move out of the body. Okay, and the gametes actually originate, did you remember the axial gland? The axial gland, which is the one of the part of the circulatory system. Yeah, so in that in a hemal system they have an axial gland. So this axial gland, the function is to produce the sex cell. So gonads, gametes are actually originate in us this axial gland, and later on they migrate into the gonads. Okay, so the starfish is a marine sedentary animal. Thus the development include indirect, and hence there are many larval stages. Okay, the fertilization is external, that is it occurs in the sea, and the fertilized egg is called as a zygote. Okay, then after the fertilization it this is a simple diagrammatic view in which depicts the life cycle of the starfish. The adult life cycle, the adult starfish will release their gametes, eggs and sperm into the environment, and in the environment or within in the particular surrounding, that is in sea water, it will get fused, and the fused one is said to be as a zygote. Then zygote get undergo cleavage in sense rapid this so cleavage is a repeated mitotic division of the zygote that will result in an increase in number of cell. Okay, the quantity remains the same, but the number, the density increases. Okay, so in this what happened, the daughter cells will be generated, and then they will give rise to the blastula. After the formation of blastula, there is invasion of the blastula cells, layer of the blastula cell take place and give rise to two layers, thus forming a gastrula, that is gastrulation. The forming in gastrulation is marked by the in gastrulation the main characteristic what happened, that is invasion of the inner layers, blastular layers will take place, invasion of the two layers, and thus give rise to the three germ layers. Okay, echinodermata is triploblastic, that is they have three germ layers. Triplo means three. Okay, ectoderm, endoderm and middle one mesoderm. Okay, So this is the formation of double layer cup like structure in a gastrula takes place, and after the gastrulation there has been different larval forms are observed. The gastrula then develop into diplurula larva, which is the one of the first characteristic larval stage found in all echinoderms. Then this diplurula larva differentiate or metamorphosize into the Brachiolaria larva, Bipinnaria larva, and then Bipinnaria larva get transformed into Brachiolaria larva, and Brachiolaria larva will metamorphosize into the young starfish, and young starfish will develop into an adult one. Okay, so this is the simple life cycle of the starfish. Okay. Then after the fertilization, that is cleavage takes place. So cleavage is what? Cleavage is the repeated mitotic division of the zygote that will result in an increase in the number cell. So here in a starfish, the cleavage is holoblastic, and the segmentation is said to be an holoblastic, equal and indeterminate. It is a rapid process, and the cleavage converts the zygote into blastula in 1 day. Okay, after the formation of blastula is a spherical and ciliated. Okay, and it has a hollow, and hence it is called as a ciloblastula. So type of blastula which is found in a starfish is the ciloblastula, means hollow. Okay, the cavity of the blastula is said to be a blastocoel, and it is surrounded by a layer of a ciliated cells. The blastula swims freely in a water. Okay, after the blastula there has been formation of gastrulation. The blastula invaginates to form a double layered cup called as a gastrula. Okay, and this gastrula is in the form of a double layered cup, and the two layers that are outer ectoderm and an inner endoderm, and the cavity of the gastrula is called as a archenteron. Okay, and it opens to the outside by an opening called as a blastopore. The endoderm at the inner end give off cells into the blastocoel, and these cells forms the mesoderm. The archenteron produces two pouches. These pouches are pinched off from the archenteron as a two sac, and this sac develop into coelom and a water vascular system. The gastrula swim in water. After few time or after some time, it develops into a larva called as a bipleurula larva. Okay, now we'll see about the it's a dipleurula larva. Okay, the dipleurula larva develop from the gastrula, and it is the fundamental larva of the echinoderms. That is, it is the first larval form in the life cycles of echinoderms. Okay, it is microscopic, free swimming larva, and it will be the bilaterally symmetrical, with the oval in shape, and has a gut formed of mouth, the esophagus, the intestine, the stomach and the anus. Okay, so dipleurula larva shows a system. Then it also has two ciliary bands. Okay, the one is termed as a perioral band, which will be found around the mouth, and another one is termed as an odoral. Okay, not I have made some mistake in typing. perioral and its odoral, odoral band, which is inside the mouth. A-D-O-R-A, not A-B-O-R-A-L, okay? It's A-D-O-R-A-L, odoral band, which is placed inside the mouth. Then the perioral band is used for locomotion, whereas the odoral band is used for collection of food. Okay, so these two bands plays an important role. That is, perioral band will help in locomotion, whereas the odoral band will help in use to collect the food. Okay. It feeds on diatoms. The dipleural larva develops into bipinnaria larva. Okay. The next larval stage is the bipinnaria larva. The bipinnaria larva is the second larva of the starfish. It develops from the dipleural larva, and it has the it is minute and microscopic. It swims freely on the surface of the water. It is bilaterally symmetrical, and it has a straight elementary canal. And this elementary canal is provided with the mouth at the anterior end, and at the posterior end it will be having an anus. Okay. And it has a preoral lobe and postoral lobe. The body has a number of outgrowth called as a arms, and these arms are covered by a ciliated bands, and these bands are used for locomotion. These arms are used for locomotion, and it has two unpaired arms and five pair of paired arms. Okay. They are median dorsal arm, median ventral arm, preoral arm, postoral arms, anterodorsal arm, posterodorsal arm, and posterolateral arm. Okay. Do you remember when we have done the practical, that is larval forms of the echinoderms? That time you have seen this bipinnaria larva. Yeah, remember, it has provided with six to seven arms. Okay, so just try to recall that picture. Okay, the next stage is brachiolaria larva. Okay, it is the third larva of the starfish. The bipinnaria larva, after a short free swimming life, it get transformed into brachiolaria larva. The preoral region of this larva has a three processes called as a brachiolar arms. In the image, at the down right hand side of the corner, you can see brachiolar arms, which is placed at the anterior part, and it will provide with the suckers. So this arms has three arms three processes, and called as a brachiolar arms. And these three arms will be having at the tip will be having a suckers. Okay, and it swims and feed like a bipinnaria larva. Okay, then the metamorphosis, that is, from the now brachiolaria larva or adult one or the young starfish is going to form. So how it get formed? In the metamorphosis, it includes several steps. We'll see one by one. That is, first what happened, the brachiolaria larva sink to the bottom of the sea. As it is the free floating larva on the surface of the water, now at the time of metamorphosis, to get change into the young one, what this brachiolaria larva does, it will sink down to the bottom of the sea, and it gets attached to the substratum with the help of the brachiolar's arms. Hence, bacuoles arms will be provided with suckers which will help them to attachment. Okay, the mouth, anus and the ciliary bands disappears, and after some time a new mouth is formed on the left side of the larva, whereas a new anus is formed on the right hand side of the larva. Okay, and the mouth represents the oral side, whereas the anus will represent the aboral side. Okay, this how the oral and the aboral sides are formed. Okay, then 5 lobes grow between the mouth and the anus, and these are the arm rudiments. The bilateral symmetry is transformed into the radial symmetry. The adult shows the radial symmetry, pentagonal radial symmetry, remember? So, as the larva is showing the bilateral symmetry, what happened? It gets transformed into the radial symmetry. Okay? This is how from the Brachiolaria larva, a new young starfish is formed. Okay, or this Brachiolaria larva differentiated into young starfish. Okay, after the regeneration means in echinoderms, especially in starfish, what happened? They show a high power of regeneration. Okay, there is considerable power of regeneration in starfish if the central disc is detached. All its arms, it will regenerate them all. A single arm with a small part of a disc will regenerate the whole animal. So they show a very high power of regeneration. Even they have one more character that is also termed as an autotomy, that is, when an arm is injured, the animal casts off its arm, and this process is called as autotomy. Okay, self detachment of its arm. If any of the arm has been injured while escaping from the predator, or while having food and all, in order to protection and all, that time they will, if any arms have been injured, they will cut off that part from their body. Okay, so it is referred to as a autotomy. Auto means self and tomy means cut. Okay, so this will help to protect the animal when it is caught by one or more arms. After casting them off, it can run away. Okay, the cast off parts regenerate, or generally regenerates later. So this is the one of the characteristic feature of the starfish. Okay, with this we have completed the type study of the starfish under the phylum Echinodermata. If you have any question regarding this topic, then please let me know. And thank you, students.